Alright, what's up guys? Welcome to... What is the episode of this? Oh, this will be episode 4. Yeah, because I gotta edit episode 3 tonight. So anyways, welcome to episode 4. So this is my primary squat and bench session. Lately, my weight has been floating around 204, 205, and that's with it being like five and a half weeks out at that point. And so now I'm 5 weeks out, still floating around 204 to 205, which come nationals, I didn't hit the 204 to 205 mark until actually the week of nationals. And then from there, the next day I was like 204 something. And then from there we gut cut, water cut, and then that brought me down to like all the way to 196 actually, which is way too much. So this time around, I've been hitting heavier weights, been a lot more comfortable with heavier lows, hitting over the 700s in squat, deadlifting the 800s, benching in the 460s, and I've been doing that at a much lower body weight than in my prep going towards nationals, and I feel better and stronger. So I'm really excited to have the squat session today, because if everything is still flying and everything still feels normal right now, then I should have no problem. We're gonna do less on the water cut and the gut cut, and I should weigh in a little bit heavier than 196. I should hopefully weigh in at like 198, so that way I can have as much strength as possible when it comes to the Arnold. So about to get started. I got a lot of clients in the building. Emily's here, and she has a big squat and deadlift, even though she's excited for. She has a big squat and deadlift that she's excited and ready for, so probably get some clips and videos of that while I'm training.
All right. juggled all the main lifts. Now I'm over to my accessories. And yes, I still do weighted dips. I just, you know, as we get closer to the Arnold and closer to meat prep in general, there's really no need for me to like put on 4 reds, 5 reds or anything like that for dips. I just need to make sure I get the volume in. And I get like good, somewhat progressive load week to week, and just, you know, make sure that I'm, you know, not ignoring these movement patterns. That's pretty much it. Because dips still help my bench, but if I overdo it like how I was before, then that'll start taking away from my bench, and then it'll also probably start taking away from my squat just because my shoulders are going to be overwhelmed. But during this, instead of music, I'm tuning into the warm-up room podcast. My coach, Marcellus Williams, the Swole Fesser, he's on there, so I'm trying to listen to everything he has to talk about. So let me get going to that. See? Super easy. So I only got like a 3x6 to 7 with these. Just the same load. Usually I'll have like a top set and then back downs with weighted dips, but right now I'm just doing straight sets with a solid weight and just building up week to week. So I'm gonna go ahead and knock out another set here in about like 20 seconds or so. And then after that, I think I have like 2 more accessories. Then that's pretty much it. With my accessories, I don't really like take a long time doing them. Even when it comes to like back downs and like squats or deadlifts or whatever, I get through my workout, especially like as I get closer to prep, just to up my conditioning. Now, of course, if I have clients in here or social hour, I'm just taking my time. I could be in here for 3-4 hours if I want to, if I have that luxury. But lately, I haven't really been having that luxury because I'm on like a very tight time schedule. So if you cramp for time and for some reason your sessions are still taking 3 hours, time your back downs and time your rest. Because if you aren't doing that, chances are you're wasting precious time. So, all right, second set. Trying to take the leg press as if it's my squat. So like whenever I squat, I don't know if you'll notice, but I do a little bit of tempo at the very beginning, and then I'll descend, and then I push back up. So for instance, this is what I'm doing with my squat. If I just focus on explosion, then this is what I would just like go to, which would be like a second set. All I do is a 3x8 and then move on. Again, closer to a meet, treat my accessories. industries to where they're getting good quality work, but I'm not pushing them to like a 2RP8 or 2RP9 because I need as much recovery as possible, especially while being just much lighter than I was, let's say, 5 months ago or whatever. So that's it for like today. Next time you guys see me, I'll be deadlifting tomorrow. So I'll see y'all tomorrow.
All right, so today is Saturday, deadlift day. Today's gonna be pretty light, only working up to 685 for the single. Next week, I believe the highest I can go is like 740, I think. I gotta double check that. But everything is just all about having good solid caps, not overexerting myself, just touching things that are like somewhat good enough for some type of stimulus, all the way leading into the Arnold. I've been waking up, just like I said, around 204, 205. This morning I woke up at 204.4. So I'm gonna start eating a little bit more because that's like too light for me. That's lighter than what I would honestly want. And today I'll be working in with Z and then Kev. So Z is my client, strong lifter. He's gonna be doing the Rising Tide meet. That's gonna be the week after the Arnold. And then Kev is one of the strongest juniors for the 6'7.5 kg class that I have seen. And I've watched him like from high school all the way to now. So we're gonna get some deadlifts in today. I'll get some footage of their top sets, not the warm-ups, but I'll get footage of all of our top sets, couple back downs, talk to y'all a little bit more, maybe show some accessories, but if not, I'll just talk to y'all about whatever today was and how everything felt, and then that should be the end of this video. So I catch y'all with those deadlifts. Deadlifts. I'm actually really excited for Z because that 540 that he did, I mean, it flew. So seeing him and seeing what he can kind of like progress his singles to be, I'm super excited about that. Y'all saw Kev. The strength was there for sure. He just kind of like let it slip on the last rep, but something that he will be working on is just kind of like his grip issues and just kind of like making sure that he's able to hold on to the bar. Strength, again, like I said, for him is just like crazy.
What's up,
buddy? No, come on. She's trying to be like, I'm dead. So, but this wraps up this episode, I believe. Yeah. So this is episode 4, technically. Yeah, so this is episode 4. This wraps up that. And one thing that Z actually brought up to me was at the beginning of this prep, or like when I started taking things serious, I was like, oh, I'm gonna be like a different person, or like I'm gonna be quiet, I'm gonna be kind of like, you know, like almost like an asshole-ish type or whatever, because that's what I'm used to. So like past prep, I went to a different gym, I didn't really train with anyone, I was usually by myself, I, you know, was on a very tight schedule, and I just like was in a very, I was in a very like complicated like place to where I wasn't at peace within myself, so I kind of went there, and that's why I had to do with all that isolation. Before that was like Virginia Pro, and for Virginia Pro Prep, I was definitely in a dark place to where I was going and working out at like 12 o'clock midnight, 10 o'clock at night sometimes, or like just always trying to go when there is nobody, and just allowed myself to just like, no matter what, like whatever pain I'm going through, whatever it is, I just want to die, like basically in the gym. That's basically where my head was and where I was at. This go around, I try to go into that same dark place and I don't need it, you know? Like, I'm still competitive, like I still have the edge, like I still have, like I'm very direct and I'm very much sticking to a very strict schedule still. But my personality doesn't have to change. My personality isn't changing whatsoever. I'm very happy when I'm here in the gym, very happy coming to Ironside like every day, doing my workouts. Whether I'm having like bad days or good days, I'm still overall in like a very healthy mental place. I'm just very determined, and I still have a lot of fuel that I'm using for this prep, but it doesn't have to pull me somewhere that I don't want to be. So it's really cool to see like my own personal growth with just lifting, life, and everything that comes in between. So that's gonna be it for this video. If, again, like these videos and want to keep them coming, please like, comment, share, subscribe, and until next time, peace. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Ain't no other niggas.